משיבס נפש, עין ווב. לפעמים בחמס השם נפתח לאדם אור גודל. ונדש ודה יהיה איש כושת הרואי. Sometimes a person, it seems to a person that he's going to be a good guy, everything's going to work out. He feels illuminated, he feels uplifted, everything's wonderful, wow. It's all going to work, it's Ein Vov. It's all going to be wonderful, it's all going to be great. Okay? He's walking on air, we call it, right? Everything's going to be great. It'll be a Yishkash Kaloi, he'll see it's starting, it's going to work, it's going to go, it's going to have a Kavana, it's going to have everything he wants, it's going to be Chesed, it's going to have a Midas, it's all going to be incredible, perfect, everything's going to work out. So the Achakach Pisa Nechshach Lohem Ki Ilu Ba Shash Mash, Pisa Shilei Bo Yitzah. Then in one second, suddenly something doesn't go right, he has a hard time, he has a Nisan, someone yells at him, someone, well, something happens, and it feels like that's it, the sun sets. Before it's time, suddenly he's completely confused, he's in the darkness, unexpectedly. So he feels like, that's it, nothing, it's all going to bleak. Now everything became bleak, never going to get anywhere, never going to do anything positive, never going to happen, it's impossible. I can't get anywhere. So the Bechines Mashanah of Yaakov, first of all, was said by Yaakov Avinu B'Ifko Amako, that he encountered the place. And we'll see in a minute, what does it say there, what happened there? So we'll see. Again, Avram Nehmar, by Yasim HaKaminocha. He says, Avram saw the place from afar, from a distance. Rav Nazan explains this means that a person, when things are difficult, he has to be like Avram, you know. Avram is on his way to sacrifice Yitzchak. As far as he knows, he has to kill him. It's a terrible tragedy. He has to kill your son, Mohammed's son. Son, who can understand what this means? Who can understand the significance of this thing? And looks into the harbory where he has to do the deed. And he sees in the boy that this one's children, great-great-great-grandchildren are going to offer us to Karbonis to Hashem. So it's a steer, it's a paradox. On the one hand, he has to slaughter his son. So no kids, no nothing. On the other hand, his son's descendants are going to be here. He doesn't understand how to work this out. He just says, okay, God told me to do it, I'm doing what he said. What it means, God can do anything, I have no idea what it means. Okay, the Yitzhar eventually wanted to cool him off and then not do it. He said, oh, you know what, actually, just bring your son on the mountain. He didn't say kill him, so it's all going to work out, it's only fine. And then the Medrash says that the punishment of a liar is they don't believe me when he tells the truth. And I said, another Bab Maisa. Told me so many of them already, who knows, can't trust you for a minute. And even though it's true. So that's Avraham Avinu, he saw it was distant, it was hard, it was far, and everything's gonna work out, he held on and he got what he needed to get. So this is kind of being far from this makom. But Yaakov it says even more, better. So Yaakov Avinu Zocha Lifkoya Mami Shumakum. He went right into the place, he came from the place, moved the place, like Sin Azar. Daf Bichain, what happens after? He's there, Mami, it's perfect, he's doing smidden, she has the he's not going to sacrifice the song with the very good. Terrible choshev. Then Avram lost his wife. It was a very, very difficult times. He said, she had a camp there. He was bed there because the sun came and it went down. It set before its time. It came suddenly dark. That's like he was saying earlier, that the moment things you, Yaakov got a higher level. He's there, everything's wonderful. He's in this middle. He came back, he passed the place where he was supposed to go. He said, wait, could it be that I didn't go to the place where my father died and I passed by and I didn't die? It's not middle, it's not possible. It's not okay, I can't allow this. He wanted to go back, and kids are there, and he went so fast. And he got to a very high place, he felt so uplifted, and suddenly what happens? It's dark. Lost it. He's in the darkness, in the gloom. What do I do now? Nozo dilo b'cholim shukol ze b'chinas v'hinei asunum motu arzo v'roish shumad yashamayim. What they show him? They show him a dream. There's a ladder. There's angels going up and going down. He said, because this process, this difficulty, when a person feels like he's so far, that's just part of the down to go up. That's the idea. You're going down, you're going up. That's where it's going. The chuzharin, the others, I think the Chayza also, that Cheder, they say that the angels in that ladder means that every mice a person does here on earth is bringing up angels, bringing down angels, doing big things. Every person we have to go from level to level, like you go up a ladder. Anyone who wants to skip levels, it doesn't work. You fall. You can't keep climbing. You have to climb it. Hold on. But things are hard. Hold on. And you move. Don't stop. Don't let go. We're on a ladder. Everything's blooming. What happened? Because you're going to sleep and you know, that's part of the process. Now it's time to go up. It's level by level. Hine Malchim Kim Unbiyarden Bo, Hanish Tsok Shir Tzadikim Shukum Kim Kamakum and the videos. The Malchim Kim go up and down, they're represented by them. These Malachim represent Tzadikim, even Tzadikim have to have ups and downs and ups and downs. This is the way it is. But how many times does it say for Yosha? There's Yimei Atomi, Yimei Ra. There's good days, better days, there's harder days. And the person has to know what to do at what time. So that means spiritually. Because it's a shirli rida, before every ascent, there's always a descent. I really tachas aliyah. Going down is the ultimate way of moving forward. Because the person he realizes he's missing, he looks to Hashem to fill him in, and Hashem gives him the next level. That's one way of explaining it. Another way of explaining it is because compared to the next level, I have absolutely nothing. So I have to realize that before I can be filled, morale says, we can't be filled in if you don't have the knowledge that you're missing. So that's why when you plant a seed in the ground, it decomposes, then it sprouts. When a hen lays an egg, the egg has to decompose, then it grows into something, into a chick. This is when the world, Hashem wanted to make the world, first was tov, avol, v'choshech, all these terrible, it's terrible, it's horrendous, it's very big minus, and then you get a plus, then you make the world. So that's how Hashem made the whole creation. So therefore, what that means is, that's part of how Hashem wants things to be. The minute you're on the next level, that's to be. You get that toe of the next level, and then you move forward. And again, the like the Quran says, push it, you have to know. The minute a person feels full, he'll never get anything. You feel full, you know it all, you're there, fine. But you don't need anything. You're not waiting for Hashem. You have to wait for Hashem, then it gives you what you need to have. But if a person is not waiting for Hashem, he's not going to get anything, because he thinks he has everything. He feels complete. That's what the, I think some morale comes out, that this is chaser. I heard this or at once. So it's chaser and chesed. They're the same. Except for one little, there's like a little point. The ratio of the dal, you have a little point. This is like the queen. It says about Shema Yisrael Shem HaKim Hashem Echad. So the Echad to Acher Chavishom, another Chavishom, is like one little point. You have to have that. It's the beginning of Chacham. Whatever you have to have your head on right to see straight and to get up to have Milamun and not Chavishom be somewhere else. So that's the same thing, chesed and chaser. When a person's chaser, Hashem does the chesed for him. When a person isn't missing anything, then there's no chesed. It's not a chesed when you don't realize you're missing. It's not a kindness. Oh, just another level, just give it to him for free. It's nothing. The person he has to work for, he has to know, he has to look to Hashem. That's why what Borcha Gifter said, he said, if you can have a little chip, you know, maybe this is getting more and more likely. You know, you have a little chip. You put it in your head, and you're right, and you suddenly in all shots you can like access your computer. You just, instead of typing, you just think, and you get the Gemara. He said, "What is that word in your Rosh?" Nothing at all, zero. You have zero. Maybe it's a great tool, but it's not really worth anything, because the whole value is the person who works on it. Like it comes up a lot of times. Or he says, because working and learning that breaks the clickness, the whole idea of breaking self to understand this puzzle's wrong, that puzzle, that's what breaks through, that's what gets him where he needs to go. Yeah. I used to tell my other person not be moved. Shouldn't be, I'm astounded, this is crazy. Again the darkness, again the gloom, what's gonna be? Shouldn't be astounded, shouldn't be you shouldn't feel flummoxed and ruined and he's in terrible trouble. But you shouldn't become discouraged. When everything goes over him, why? It's so hard. Yeah, you have to get to this point where you know that you're on a new level and I have to, you're now to get these new levels, to get to really bring it in, not just because of Malchus, which is all dark, but to bring it in the aura, slowly but surely, according to where I'm holding.
Says,
Shouldn't get confused for anything. He saw something, he was uplifted, he was doing good. He shouldn't make mistakes. Oh, this is my level, this is where I'm staying. Always illuminated. That's not how it works. There's illumination. And it's fun to move forward, to bring illumination again, to get the next level, the next level. There's no such thing as to me, if there's total light, it's not getting anywhere. There's something wrong that, he says, in order to make most music, generally speaking, in terms of almost every bit of music, you make music by a combination of notes and silence. So you have to have those blanks in the middle to make the sound to be meaningful. If you just hit a note, it has no meaning. You can't just hit a note, you hit lots of notes. There's no pauses, it's almost impossible to make music like that. I actually heard this one guy who's doing it, he had a 48-year symphony or something he made up, and there's no pause or something. Okay, I don't know, he's an unusual gentleman, but usually most musicians know you gotta have a pause in the middle, and that's the way it works. So for a person to make his life a song to Hashem, there's the ups and the downs, the difficulties, and there's a good plunge. So we have to expect it. It's like having a map. So you have a map. Yeah, there's going to be ups and downs. Oh, okay. So everything you hit a hill, oh no, a down. Okay, it's on the map. What's the problem? That's the way it is. Why are you feeling so confused? Why are you feeling so flummoxed? That's just the way it is. Big deal. He said, don't think that when you have a little list, it's yours. You're there. Oh, he's on a level. Like, hey, there's a diamond of mine. He's no, it's still very far, very distant. And he said, look, he's going to have a little bit of a little. Since he doesn't feel such that cocky, he's not on this level or anything, he just feels to give, it's just from Hashem for now, we know that happy is ups and downs. So if it goes away, it goes away. No problem. That was anyway not really mine. Should have a kiddush reading in the middle of the movie. Okay, it's you. On the way to Aliyah, keep the MSL, Pichena, Orshit, Vaherlo, the Lichper. The light that you had, that's the mistake people make. They say, well, if I don't feel it now, it's gone. It's forever gone. It was just an illusion. Said, no, it's not an illusion. It hasn't gone out. V'lo yistach b'mana chas v'shalom. It'll never, ever go away, because that's the cloud that he says, Kedusha, when any light hits any place, it leaves a trace forever. That's what he says. It comes out of many different places, it's still this idea. The minute a certain light hits on it, it's forever. You can't lose it, no matter what you do. Ki or chastu yisbarach meir olof tomer Hashem's chesed, always shining on him. Like a kol of a chis, me mech tomer lachmo, it's all, he sees it from far. But chis, bayara, sabak mrocho, he sees it from far, a distance. He's on the way. Everything's gonna work out. It's amazing. Everything's gonna be okay. How? He has no idea. No, that's an implied. It's also parnasa. Person says, "My goodness, I have not a penny. What am I gonna do? You know, I got totally. I like the bills. I like this. It's like impossible. It's impossible." I said, "No, it's gonna work out. It's gonna help me till now. Help me from now. It's gonna work out. And then somehow things more or less come together this way, that way, or the other way." That's an angular man says. Aber sof ko sof yik mar shem mish bar mash yis khir me end shem will finish what he started fi ita of in pla yis so clever pati is will make better of life so on every person personally a chikhim yis mit sap mish with tom he have to hope for deliverance always kama she never ki shu asking vini kol yom mit sap mishua like it says we are hoping for your Yeshua at all times waiting for your Yeshua. Shashim Zohar to the Orb, Mimech Tevet Achma, not to be confused for anything, no matter what.